Hello everyone, welcome back. This is lecture 4, class 9, subject English. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss one chapter of Beehive, that is chapter number 8, Reach for the Top. Part 2, Maria Sharapova. As we have discussed the explanation of the chapter, this part 2, in previous lecture. So, in this lecture, we will see further explanation of the same. In this lecture, we will discuss the brief summary, then the theme of the chapter, the aptness of the title, and message conveyed through this story, value points, and then we will discuss the homework solutions that is related to some questions that were given in the last lecture. Start with the summary of this chapter, chapter number 8, part 2, Maria Sharapova. Although Maria is fond of fashion, singing and dancing, she focuses all her attention on tennis. She considers tennis as both a business and a sport, which has poured riches in her life. However, her main aim is to shine as a tennis player. It is this aspiration that constantly governs her mind and motivates her for ceaseless efforts. As she was in her teenage and like other girls, she was also fond of fashion, singing and dancing, but she was determined enough to set a height in the world of tennis. At the tender age of 9, she left her home in Siberia, that is in Russia, to get training in tennis. She went to Florida in USA with her father. Maria suffered a painful separation from her mother for a period of 2 years. She could not see her father too as he remained busy working and arranging funds for all her needs. At such a tender age, that means at such a small age, an early age, that is 9 years, she left her home to get herself trained in tennis. And she also suffered a painful separation from her mother at that age when she needed her mother the most. And also, as she had to stay in hostel, she could not even meet her father so often. She was bullied by her seniors, and being a foreigner, she had to suffer all that patiently. Maria did not feel depressed. Rather, she was prepared for greater insults too in order to achieve her aim. She was humiliated, she was insulted by her seniors in one or the other way. And being a foreigner, she had to suffer all those humiliations without saying a word. She did not feel depressed. She did not quit that time. Instead, she was becoming mentally tough to face such humiliations in her future. Her mantra for success is to work hard and face the toughest competition. Although she was trained in the US, she considers herself to be a Russian and is willing to represent Russia at the Olympics too. So though she was trained in the US, but by blood she was a Russian, and she said in her speech that she would like to represent Russia at the Olympics. Her favorite hobbies are fashion, singing and dancing. She loves reading novels written by Arthur Conan Doyle. Her love for fashionable evening gowns is in contrast to her liking for pancakes with chocolate spread and orange flavored aerated drinks. The monetary gains and the fame incurred by Maria are well deserved. Like other teenage girls, she was also a liker of fashion, singing and dancing. She also loved to read novels and also liked to wear fashionable gowns, but on the other hand, she would also like to eat pancakes with chocolate spread and orange aerated drinks. That was in contrast, as she had to maintain her physical health in order to be a good tennis player. The monetary gains and the fame that she achieved are well deserved. Now let's discuss the main characters of this chapter. The first main character is Maria Sharapova, about whom we are reading this chapter. Maria's father brought her to the US to be trained in tennis when she was barely 9 years old. Her mother Yelena could not accompany her due to visa restrictions. In the US, she missed her mother badly, but she knew that the sacrifice was an inevitable part of her big aspirations. At such an early age, she sacrificed a lot just to build her name fame in the world of tennis. Apart from the pangs of separation from the mother, the child also suffered harassment from her inconsiderate fellow trainees who were older in age. At the training academy, Maria would go to bed at 8 p.m. as she was very young. Her fellow trainees would return at 11 p.m. and to bully her, would wake her up and make her tidy the room. That was a kind of harassment done to Maria when she was just 9 years old by her trainees, by her seniors. And as she was a foreigner, she had to bear all such nuisance without saying a word. Instead of getting frustrated at this treatment, Maria saw its positive side and drew mental strength from this humiliation. This mental toughness gradually became a trait of her personality that helped her both as a person and as a sportswoman. It proved to be instrumental in helping her to reach the zenith of glory in the world of tennis. Instead of getting depressed or instead of quitting at that very moment, she saw the positive side of such humiliations and thus became mentally tough. That actually proved to be helpful in reaching the heights in the world of tennis. She bagged the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004 and became the number one tennis player in the world. Hard work, dedication and mental courage paved the way to success for Maria Sharapova. Imbued with patriotic sentiments, she feels proud to be a Russian. Though grateful to the US for bringing out the best in her, she would like to represent her own country, Russia, at the Olympics. Although Maria is fond of fashion, singing and dancing, she focuses all her attention on tennis only. She considers tennis as both a business and a sport which has poured riches in her life. However, her main aim is to shine as a tennis player. It is this aspiration that constantly governs her mind and motivates her for ceaseless efforts. Though she was fond of other things also, but the main thing that was all time on her mind was to shine in the world of tennis. And that is the only strength, that is the only source of strength for her to achieve the desired heights what she had deserved. Maria's parents, Yuri and Irina Sharapova, are Maria Sharapova's father and mother respectively, and their contribution to her success is immense and cannot be measured in words. They identified their daughter's potential at a very young age and decided to get her world-class training in the US. So, her parents' contribution cannot be measured in words, as they also sacrificed many things to get Maria achieved her aims. They knew well that it was going to be expensive and difficult. Still, they extended their full support to their talented daughter. Yuri worked very hard to pay for Maria's training, and Yelena tolerated the heart-wrenching separation from her dear child for 2 years. As parents, they displayed unflinching faith in their child's abilities, which gave Maria the boost to keep going ahead and to keep countering the challenges that came her way. So her parents' support, who worked very hard in every aspect to get her daughter a achieve her aims and desired goals gave her boost, gave her energy to keep going ahead and to tolerate and bear those humiliations also. Now let's see the value points. Maria Sharapova was born in Siberia in Russia in 1987. She led a charge of Russian players who came to achieve great success in the women's game. She has brought her own brand of glamour to tennis by designing her own unique tennis outfits. At the 2007 in US Open, she wore a dress with over 600 crystals sewn into it. She got her first tennis racket when she was 4 from the father of Grand Slam winner Yevgeny Kafelnikov. At the age of 6, she attended a tennis clinic in Moscow run by Martina Navratilova, who recognized her talent and recommended that she should go to the USA to study at a famous tennis academy in Florida. She moved to the USA with her father in 1994. Neither of them could speak English. They had very little money and went to the tennis academy by bicycle every day. She turned professional in 2001 and a year later became the youngest girl ever to reach the junior final at Wimbledon. So this was all such sacrifices being done by her parents as well as by Maria to achieve the heights in the world of tennis. She won her first Grand Slam title at Wimbledon when she was 17. She is one of several top players who are known for loud on-court grunting. She has been the world's highest paid sportswoman and the women's number one several times. So this was all the achievements being achieved by Maria. The theme of the chapter is: the account is biographical in nature and focuses on the grand achievements of the tennis player Maria Sharapova, who earned the title of the world number one in women's tennis in 2005. The author reveals that one has to pay a price for reaching the top in the form of hard work, hard labor, rigorous training and sacrifice. Sometimes one has to undergo mental torture too on this path to success. But it is rewards that are always sweet and satisfying. So that was the theme of the chapter, that one has to go through certain sacrifices and humiliations in order to achieve the sweetest reward of everything out of that, and that is the success and the satisfaction the person gets after bearing those humiliations. Let's discuss the aptness of the title. The title "Reach for the Top" is very appropriate for this account of Maria Sharapova's journey as a top class tennis player. This journey started with early training in her childhood and culminated in her becoming the number one in the world of tennis. The top symbolizes the highest point reached by Maria Sharapova. So this title is apt as this account of Maria Sharapova represents a journey that started with sacrifices and ends with the achievement of all the desired goals. She reached this top means the height, by the dint of her earnest efforts and diligent work. Thus, the title is apt in that it salutes the courage and strong willpower of this young tennis star who overcame all hardships and obstructions to reach the top of the tennis world. Message: this account of Maria Sharapova's success story conveys the message that diligence, hard work and dedication never go unrewarded. Dreams can be realized only if one works earnestly, putting one's heart and soul in translating them into reality. Nothing can obstruct those who stick to their path with an unstaggering devotion. That is the message conveyed through this story, an inspirational account of a young tennis player, Maria Sharapova. Now let's discuss the homework solutions. The first question: what was Maria's mantra for success? And the answer is, Maria's mantra for success was that she took all her challenges heads on. She never shy away from difficult tasks. As a person, she was very competitive and never left anything incomplete. Competition drove her into doing things with utmost hard work and compassion. Question number 2: what role did Maria Sharapova's parents play in her success? Answer: Maria's parents played an essential role in her success, as they worked hard to achieve her goal and also encouraged her and did not let her lose hope. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States by her parents. Third question: how was Maria treated by her fellow students at Florida? Answer: she was treated very badly at Florida, and also she was very young at that time. She used to go to bed at 8 p.m. whereas the other pupils would come in at 11 p.m. and wake her up in order to tidy up the room and clean it. Next question: why did Maria Sharapova leave Siberia for USA? Maria, the legendary tennis player, was sent to the United States to undergo her training on tennis in early life. The trip which she availed with her father to Florida elevated her on the success and stardom. Now your homework is that you have to read the chapter thoroughly, this part 2, Maria Sharapova, and complete the questions after matching your answers with the solutions provided in the FAIR notebook. Write down the chapter name, chapter number, and complete questions, and then you will write their answers. Do your work in proper format in your FAIR notebook.